So doing my 50-hour service, changing oil filter. Then I took my plate off. This is why I always take a, here, let me get that to focus. Look at that. Wonder how much this week I would have made on that guy. I think that was getting ready to leave me in not a happy spot. And look here, just noticed that one, look there. This belt, I don't know how much, I've put 100 hours on this belt. I don't know what it had. This belt's probably got 200 hours on it. So my 50-hour service is now going to turn into taking this tensioner off and replacing this belt. Luckily, I had one in the shop already. So there we go. All right, so I don't have a book on this mower, and I just YouTubed it real quick to see if anybody else has, because I've never changed the belts on this, and I couldn't find anything. So this is the tension, and it's hooked to that little hook right here, which is bolted right there. So I think if I just screw around with the camera here, it'll just magically fix itself. Well, my camera doesn't want to. So this is just a half inch. Oh, it's pretty loose already. So, oh, that wasn't right. So I loosened that up. Thought I'd be able to I thought I would be able to loosen that. Yeah. Let me shut this camera down. I thought I'd be able to loosen that little spring that way, but apparently it's not gonna be that easy. That's a pretty thick freaking spring, so I didn't wanna have to do anything funky to fight with it. I mean, that thing's got some, yeah, it's gonna have some freaking beef on it. I don't think that's, I can get enough tension on that to muscle it back, but we'll see. Try to loosen the back end of this up, which I thought for a second I was going to have to take it all the way out. So there, I don't know if what we can see or what we can't. So now the tensioner is off, and now I can loosen this belt off now. So let's do that. Need to do, like, discovering a little spot. There's back here where I can't get my freaking fingers on. And other than that, the belt's off other than that. This one teeny little spot on the inside of right here. I'll show you guys in a minute. Here, I'll show you guys right now. So, let's see if that. So when I'm trying to take this off, it's getting stuck right there on that. You can see where it's rubbing. I can't get it out of there. So I'm thinking I might have to take this spindle off top of this right here to get that stupid belt out of there. I'm gonna wrestle with it for a minute and then get that shit apart, I guess. I don't wanna cut it. My belt looks a little different, though I think it's the right belt. So let's wrestle with it a minute and see what I gotta do. Alright guys, what I had to do, I could not for the life of me get that belt pulled out of there. So I just took my knife and cut that last little bit that was holding it. And then getting it back in was really easy. I just put it in right here, got it seated in the lip, and just did like that, and it rolled right in. So now I've got, I got everything where it needs to be. Now I've just got to bring those back together, and then I'll tighten that up, and then that should be good on the belt.
It's almost there. I'm not getting up to the angle I want. The springs are tight. Alright. So now,
looks like a long pulley, man. It's a big ass pulley. So this is a little nut on the outside. And all that's doing is pulling this tighter now.
I think that'll be what we're looking for. So yeah guys, if you have, if anybody knows stuff I was missing to get the belt to come off of that pulley without it being totally broke, let me know so I know for next time.
See if I can get it off of this one. Oh, yeah.
I'm just not with it today. My belt's got me all. The belt's got me all flushed in. Can't get my... Jeez. There's no reason to have an oil filter on that, I think. Oh, smokes. Okay, the red filter.
I normally do this, for the most part, every week. I did not do it last week. So this is 2 weeks worth of, 2 weeks worth of gunk. Uh-huh. I'll put you to work.